بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Brothers and sisters in Islam, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. What a great pleasure and honor and happiness it is for me to see you again. It is a delight for me, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our work and yours. Honestly, I am benefiting from you more than what you are benefiting from me. And this experience for me, inshallah, will benefit me a lot going back to the people in Australia. So please don't forget me and us and my colleagues and the Muslims in Australia and around the world, of course, from your dua. Always make dua for our success, inshallah ta'ala, and make your intentions good. Brothers and sisters in Islam, today's topic, our brothers have chosen the following title: what are your priorities in life? Subhanallah, this question is extremely crucial. What are your priorities in life? Or what is your priority in life? Brothers and sisters in Islam, I would like this evening for you and I to think about this question deeply. Think about it properly. I'll tell you why. Al-Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, حاسبوا أنفسكم قبل أن تحاسبوا. Hold yourself to accountability. Judge yourself before you are ultimately judged, before you are held accountable on the ultimate day. الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم الذي لا ينطق عن الهوى إن هو إلا وحي يوحى. He never speaks out of his own desire, except that it's an inspiration sent down to him from above, said, judge yourself before you are judged. By who? Before you are judged by the ultimate judge, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. On the day when He will make us stand, whether we like it or not. The day when Ibrahim alayhi salam will fall to his knees on the ground. And he will say, Allahumma sallim, Allahumma sallim. O Allah, please give us peace, give us peace. On that day when every messenger and prophet will run away from the responsibility of having to answer for us and will say, I only have myself to worry about. On that day, you will be judged. You will be questioned. You and I will be questioned about every single letter we uttered. Yes, I know. It is a burdening task. Yes, I know it creates a burden upon us right now. But a person who judges themselves is in a better position than anyone who neglects themselves. Did you not hear the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran? Nasullaha, nasullah, nasullah, fa'ansahum anfusahum. فَأَنْسَاهُمْ أَنفُسَهُمْ. They forgot Allah. They neglected Allah. So then Allah made them forget who they are. Allahu Akbar. Are you listening to this verse carefully? Allah is speaking about those who forgot Allah's verses. Allah who neglected those who forgot, who neglected Allah their Creator and turned to other things as being their objective. Turn to other things as being the most important thing for them. Turn to other things which they should strive for and reach instead of Allah. Allah says they forgot Allah by being distracted by other things other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Until what? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made them forget who they even are. Made them forget their own identity. Made them forget who you are and what is your purpose. Where are you heading? نَسُوا اللَّهَ فَأَنْسَاهُمْ أَنفُسَهُمْ. They forgot Allah, so then Allah made them forget themselves. This is something natural. This is something normal to occur.